As functionality is added to a model, it can grow in size and complexity. To manage that complexity, you can use subsystems to create modularity that hides details and simplifies the appearance of a model. To see and navigate the subsystems, you can use the model browser accessible from the graphical palette. You can create a subsystem by selecting a group of blocks and right-clicking on the Create Subsystem option. This creates a subsystem block with input and output ports. You can rename these ports to indicate the signals entering and leaving the subsystem. Here, the shaft speed is the output signal and the voltage is the input signal. If you want to remove the subsystem but keep the content in order to reorganize the model hierarchy, you can do so by clicking on the Expand Subsystem option from the right-click menu. Masking a subsystem allows you to change the appearance of a subsystem and add an interface to change the parameters used by the subsystem. To mask a subsystem, use the Create Mask option from the right-click menu. This opens a mask editor where you can change the appearance of a subsystem, add a set of parameters that determines the behavior of a subsystem, add an initialization code, and provide documentation. Let's see how you can do this step by step. There are multiple ways of adding an icon or image to the subsystem as explained in the examples here. I'm going to add an image from a graphics file. This changes the appearance of a subsystem in the block diagram. Using the Parameters and Dialog tab, you can control a set of parameters from the underlying subsystem. Using the Edit control from the control palette, motor inertia can be added to the parameter list. The Promote Parameter option is used to promote a parameter from the underlying subsystem, such as the motor resistance parameter. A simple motor schematic will help in understanding all these parameters. To do this, first add image to the first group box and next specify the file path to the image. The preview button shows how the new dialog interface will look like. The documentation tab is used to add a short description that appears on the block dialog interface. I can add a detailed explanation of the underlying subsystem in the mask help section in the form of raw text, URL, or HTML, which will be accessed from the help button on the block dialog interface. Double-clicking on the subsystem block, you can see the mask dialog interface that was just created and change the parameter values. You can now reuse the subsystem by simply making copies of it and changing the parameters associated with each instance of the subsystem. Running the simulation shows the different results for the two copies of the subsystem.